Hey guys, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to round one of Theros Draft here on Channel Fireball. We decided to keep our opening hands pretty good. We cannot cast our Cavern Lamphead, but we can cast our Wingseed Rider, and we'll probably be able to cast our Helioid's Emissary too. Don't even think I put on the Rider yet, but you know, we have a lot of that stuff in our deck, so probably find something. And anecdotally, I play the right number of white sources because I can cast my guy in turn three. But, you know, that doesn't mean anything. I still really want to figure that out a little better. Alright, what do you got? So, possibly, just based on the lands in this, a red-green kind of big mana deck, which is a thing. People from Florida seem to like it. Maybe he has some Boulder Falls in there, who's to say? Took a lightning strike from you. Feel good about that. I don't really know if I took it from him. Who knows where he was sitting. Well, at least he didn't use the mana from that. Oh, nope, he did. What you got here? Alright. A thought seize that we cannot cast. Yeah, I think we just want an emissary and also attack. Next turn we can tap down something, have Battlewise Valor, also cast Traveling Philosopher. Just get a lot of stuff we can do next turn. So presumably he'll leave this back. He might even leave this back. It's kind of awkward for him. He has to leave. I mean, he has to leave both back or leave neither back, I guess. But the Valor does help things a bit for us. We'll see what he has. Could just have a Lightning Strike here. Oh, that's annoying. Does choose to attack. Okay. Well, I don't know what we're looking for here. Probably a black land would be good. I guess that would be pretty good. I could Thoughtseize. Probably some big thing in hand. Eh, that's not a bad draw either. So if I just bash and play this, I will take 4. Eh, who cares? Alright. Also make it impossible to block for the rest of the game, so I can like that part. So I guess if I were to enchant or bestow this on this, then I get to do it twice with the same creature, right? Well, that's pretty sweet. Probably not necessary. Not man. Man! Screwing up my plans. Well, I thought I was going to take 4. Instead I'm going to take 7. It's worse for me. It's worse for me. Also, this Thoughtseize is getting worse as the game goes on. That's what Thoughtseize does. Alright. I don't know that I actually want to attack here. Like, only Sedge Scorpion's bad for me. Or, like, only that can really get through because I have the Battlewise Valor, so. I think we'll hang out. See, it's a good thing I didn't pick that first Thoughtseize because I gotta just have 2 Thoughtseize sitting in my hand right now. That's logic. Also, when I was looking at my black cards, I somehow missed the Thoughtseize. I don't know where it was in the piles, but that would be another reason why I want six black. Not that turn one Thoughtseize is like important in any way in Limited, but. I mean, I'll cast it turn one if I have no other play, but, you know, it's not like Constructed where, like, oh, I gotta stop them from doing some broken thing. Oh, got our Swamp. I don't know if I'm gonna Lamp it or Thoughtseize. We'll see what he does. That's annoying. What do I want to do here? This guy is going to be a problem. Don't really have a way to deal with him. I can start bashing for an unblockable 5, which is a 4 turn clock. It's better than attacking for 4. Can also sorry. I can chump this for one of the turns. Yeah, it's gonna be hard for me to win this game, that's for damn sure. It's one turn away from Monster Sing. Sitting back's like really bad for me. Trading the Heliod's Emissary for the said Scorpion is also pretty bad. I guess if he doesn't Monstrous, I can like bestow and then I can block. Like, I don't think he played a land last turn, so I might not be able to Monstrous, though he can always just Monstrous instantly with this, I guess. Ugh. I guess I can just hope to draw a stream of chump slash answers or something. I don't think I really want to be casting Thoughtseize right now, anyway. Yeah, alright. Sure. Six, seven, eight. So, I'm not dead on the crackback, but I probably would rather just leave this back to block one of those guys. Actually, I guess I have to chump block the Asp because of the threat of Monstrous. I don't know how I'm winning this game. I don't think I am. I would say this did not go according to plan. Yeah. Like, you could just attack with everything, and I basically just have to block this. Or well, now you can just Monstrous either way. So I have to block this. Gonna need something pretty good to not die here. I don't think I know what it is or have it, but I need it. Six, seven, eight. Well, I'm not dead. I'm going to lose, but I'm not dead. All right, what we got? Well, that's not good enough. I suppose I'll concede. Multiple times to feed. Time to feeds is pretty annoying. I think I might side in. The Boon. It's pretty good against that card. also might want Divine Verdict for Nessian Asp. So we can probably do without Battlewise Valor. I think we can actually probably do without this guy too. He's pretty bad against Asp. Not that, I mean, he might only have one Asp, I really don't know. This side could be stupid to side out, but... Yeah, could also side out Blood Tull Harpy. It's not the worst idea. Yeah, maybe something like that. Yeah, we'll give that a try.